Road trips take us to places we've never been before. They keep us grounded, reminding us that we are a diverse country, both in landscape and in people. That we are a country made up of communities, families, and friendships connected together like a web. We get so used to our daily life and routine that we often forget about others, acting as strangers. It's not until we step out of that daily mindset that we see one another as people instead and recognize how much we rely on each other. Most frequently forgotten and taken for granted are this nation's veterans. We've seen the images and heard the talk on the news, but how many of us can say we've made an effort to interact with those in the military community? The gap between the military and civilian worlds has never been this wide. We at Has Heart, a grassroots nonprofit organization, are setting out to bridge that divide with art and design with help from the creative community. Through a 50-state living and working road trip, we will connect, document, and share the stories of our country's veterans, serving as a reminder of what little distance there is among us. We look forward to seeing you on the road.
The day after I met Kendra, I had to travel to China for work. I didn't have her number, so I couldn't just text her while I was gone, so I had to figure out a creative way to ask her out from halfway across the world. While I was working at the factory, I thought drawing a little post-it note picture and sending a private message on Instagram would be my best shot.
This is what led to our first date. Dear Kendra, if I were interested in getting to know you better, would you prefer it to be over? That was cute though. Hands down the best way I've been asked out on a date, for sure. Hi, my name is Kendra Klappelgain, and I'm the communications director of Has Heart.
And I'm Tyler Way, the co-founder and creative director for Has Heart.
So I became involved with Has Heart on our second date. He walked me through the Has Heart Art Prize venue here in Grand Rapids. My first thought was, he has two jobs, basically. It was a lot of work for him and Michael to do by themselves. And so I began helping him. Just kind of through our relationship, I started volunteering more and more with the organization. I have a background in communications and journalism with a specialization in writing. But it wasn't until I quit my job as a fashion buyer that I kind of took a more active role as the communications director here.
In 2010, I was introduced to Michael Hyacinth, an 8-year U.S. Navy veteran. When we met for coffee for the first time, we realized there was a severe disconnect between his world as a veteran and then my world as a creative. From our conversation, we recognized this need to connect and intersect our two worlds. Then, shortly after, Michael met a local Marine that was not only paralyzed from the neck down, but he was also unable to speak due to injuries he suffered while serving in Iraq. Through his full-time nurse, Michael discovered this veteran's passion for t-shirts. That's when Michael called me up and asked if I'd be interested in working with this veteran to create a design that told his story. It was through that powerful, collaborative design process that we were inspired to create the Hero Series. The Hero Series partners one veteran with one artist with the shared mission to tell their story through the mediums of art, design, and fashion.
So for the past 5 years, we've done a Hero Series each year with 5 veterans and 5 artists, and that's where we would enable them to collaborate and tell their story. And we've gotten that to a point where, okay, we know the impact and the power that there is in that process, so how do we reach more people with it? And that's where we've kind of decided, well, let's take it across the country ourselves. So we'll be spending our next 18 months living and working on the road for Has Heart.
I think this project needs to be in the format of a road trip because there needs to be connections made between these locations. There's something that needs to tie all these people together, all of these veterans, all these civilians, all of these creatives. It's not something that you're going to feel if you're doing this through the internet. It needs to be a face-to-face conversation.
So each state will partner one veteran with one artist and enable them to come together for 2 days. The first day, they'll just kind of get to know each other. The veteran will share their story while the artist is kind of taking notes. And
yeah, when they meet, it's kind of like a blind date. A little awkward at first, but once they get to know each other, you know, creative juices start flowing.
Then by that second day, they start with design concepts and really kind of hone in on what their design story and their purpose and message is in their design.
Not only are we just doing design, but we're also conveying the story behind the design, because we found out that that is really the most powerful part sometimes, you know? I think the t-shirt, original to kind of our history, but it's also an opportunity for people to wear that message, walk around, share it with others. You know, when I wear my t-shirts, people always ask me. So it really creates like a narrative. It creates a conversation. That shirt that you purchased, there's a story, there's a blog post behind it. There are photos, there's video from the state that it was designed in. And so it really is all encompassing. I think there are a lot of mediums. They exist to bring us together, but oftentimes they're what pushes us apart. Has Heart is providing a way to connect, you know, something that is more engaging, something that also is appreciative. People enjoy art, people enjoy design, people want to know more, and I think that this creative process really engages the veteran as well as empowers them. Connecting them with this artist is just amplifying their voice even further. Our biggest hope for this tour will be to really change the rhetoric around veterans. Frequently, we have our participating veterans say, "I never knew that someone wanted to hear my story." And to me, that's so shocking because they have experienced so much that I haven't experienced, and so I'm eager to listen to them. I want to know more. It really reminds veterans that their stories are important.
Having a veteran sit across the table from a creative that they don't know, but someone that is eager to listen to their story, and not only listen, but also ask questions and learn more, and then help them tell that story. That's really where that power of connection quickly multiplies, because a lot of people come together, and it's really around these two people creating this one design and this one story.
Not only do we have these corporate level sponsorships, but we also have individual state sponsorships, and those are necessary to get this entire project done. And we feel like it was a really good way to engage smaller companies, even individuals, families, people that are passionate about our cause, and allow them to be part of a bigger picture.
You know, the right people will come in at the right time and support us and support the organization and the veterans and artists that we work with.